In this video, I am explaining how to sort the numbers in ascending order. Let us take the example of block of data size 5 numbers and stored in the memory location starting from 30H. So in 30H, 05 is stored. In 31H, let us assume 03 is stored. In 32H, 06 is stored. In 33H, 0B, and in 34H, 02. So 5, 3, 6, B, 2 are the data stored in the memory location from 30H to 34H. So the expected output is, we should get the smallest number in the top of the array and largest element in the bottom of the array. So then we get 3, 5, 6, B. So now to sort these number in ascending order or in the descending order, we need to compare between the elements present in the block. So let us go through step by step how to compare all the data given in the block. So to compare, minimum we require 2 numbers, and let us take this as first iteration. First we'll compare 05 and 03. So here we have to see that which number is greater and which number is lesser. So according to our program, we want the smallest element in the top of the array. So if the element is less than the other element, then we need to interchange the element. So in the first case, the first element is 5 and the second element is 3. So 3 is less than 5, so we need to interchange the data. So means in 30H we need to place 03 and in 31H we need to place 5, and in this iteration the remaining numbers will be same. Okay, so again similarly, now 2 numbers we have compared. Similarly, we need to compare now 05 and 06. So same thing needs to be done here. We need to see which one is smaller and which one is greater. If the second element is smaller than this one, then we need to interchange, otherwise those numbers should be remains same. So in this case, 06 is larger than 05, so no need of interchange. So in this iteration, our block of data looks like this. So next we need to compare now 06 with 0B. Even in this case also, 0B is greater than 06, then no need of the interchange. So our block of data looks like this. We have 03, 05, 06, 0B, 02. And next we need to compare 0B with 02. So here 02 is less than 0B, so we need to interchange. Means 02 we need to place in place of 0B, and 0B should be kept in place of 02. So our block of data looks like this. 02 and 0B. So now observe that the largest element among the array we got in the bottom of the array. So now this is one iteration, but still we have not got the expected output, so we need to continue the comparison. So and that will become now our second iteration, and these are number of comparison. So we can call now two things here. this one, how many times we are going to repeat our comparisons is as a outer loop, and inner, how many comparisons we do between the numbers as a inner loop. So for the second iteration, our block of data will looks like this. That is, at 30H we have 0, 3, 31H will have 0, 5, 32H will have 0, 6, 33H will have 0, 2, and 34 we have 0, B. So in the first iteration, the number of comparisons are 4. So now here, same thing we have to repeat what we have done in the first iteration. That is, first again we need to compare the elements which are present in which are present in 30H and 31H. So whichever is lesser, that should be there in the top of the array. So now in this case, no need of any changes. So because 0, 3 is less than 0, 5, so our array remains same. Next we need to compare 0, 5 with 0, 6. In this case also, 0, 5 is less than 0, 6, so then no need of any changes, then this will be same. Next we need to compare 0, 6 with 0, 2. So in this case, 0, 2 is smaller than 0, 6, so we need to interchange the data. Means we need to place this 0, 2 in 32H location and 0, 6 in 33H location, and of we get the block of data like this. That is 0, 2, 0, 6, 0, P. So at the end of the second iteration, we can see the two largest numbers are placed from the bottom of the array. Those are 0B and 0, 6. Again, we no need to compare 0, 6 and 0B because already the 0B is the largest element which we have kept in the bottom of the array in the first iteration itself. So in this one, the number of comparison done are 3. So still our output is not in the form of ascending order, so we need to repeat the loop. So now we'll call this one is the third iteration, and for the third iteration, the inputs are like this. In 30H, 0, 3 is stored, and then 0, 5, 0, 2, 0, 6, and 0, B. Again, same thing needs to be done. First, we are going to compare 0, 3 with 0, 5. Any of 0, 3 is lesser, so no need of any changes. We get the data like this. So next, we need to compare 0, 5 with 0, 2. So in this case, 0, 2 is smaller than 0, 5. So we need to interchange. So we get 0, 2 here and 0, 5 in the next location, and we got already 0, 6 and 0, B. So again here we don't need to compare 5 and 6 because in the second iteration already we kept two largest elements in the bottom of the array. So the number of comparisons in the third iterations are 2. So still again our data is not in ascending order, so we need to repeat the loop. So we'll call this one as a fourth iteration. So the in the fourth iteration, the input data look like this. That is 0, 3, 0, 2, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, B. So now we need to compare here 0, 3 and 0, 2. So in this case, 0, 2 is smaller than 0, 3. So we need to interchange. So here we got 0, 3, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, B, and then we no need any comparisons because in each iteration we were keeping the largest element in the bottom of the array. So finally our numbers are in the ascending order, means the most largest element is in the bottom of the array and the smallest element in the top of the array. So now we can observe here the number of iteration we have got here, the total 1, 2, 3, 4, and even inner, in the first iteration, 4 comparisons, in the second iteration, 3 comparisons, In the third iteration, two comparison, and in the last iteration, we have one comparison. So here we need to define two loops. One is for the outer loop and the other one is for the inner loop. So here in this case we have four iterations. So if we see the relation between the number of iteration and the number of data, the block size is number of iterations are less than, if the number of elements are 5, then the number of elements will be 4. If the number of elements are 6, then the number of comparisons will be 5, means block size minus 1. And for the inner loop, in each iteration, the number of comparisons are gets reduced. So for example, if we say the outer loop, if we initialize 4, in the first step, the number of comparisons are 4. In the next iteration, if the counter gets reduced to 3, even the number of comparisons are also 3. So that's why we need to copy the outer loop value to the inner loop value. So now we'll see that how to implement this logic as a 8051 programming. So first thing here we need to initialize is outer loop counter. So that is, here we have taken block size is 5. So the inner loop counter is initialized with 0, 4, 8. So any register can be used to use as a counter. So next we need to initialize the source pointer to locate the data. So in our example, the data are stored from in the internal memory location starting from 38. So let us take R0 is 38. It's nothing but we are initializing the R0 as a pointer and pointing to 38 location. And next, initialize the inner loop counter. So here we have seen that the number of comparison will be same as the count of the outer loop. So we need to copy the value of outer loop to the inner loop, means we need to copy the contents of R1 to contents of R2. But in 8051, we don't have option to move from register to register. So we use the instruction this. That is, move R2, 01H is 01H is address of the R1. So after this instruction, the R2 will get 04H. That is contents of R1. So now here we are done with the initialization of the counters and the source pointer. So next we need to access first two datas to compare. So for that, we'll access first data into accumulator, that is move A@R0. According to this instruction, the A will get the first element of the array. That is, the first element of the array, which in example we have taken is 0, 5. And next we need to get the second element. For that, we need to increment R0. Okay, right. So now here we need to So in this case, to sort the numbers in ascending or descending, we have to see that which number is larger and which number is smaller. So that can be identified by checking the carry flag. So carry flag sets in during two operation, that is when we do the subtract or when we compare two numbers. So any method can be used. We can use the subtraction or we can use the comparisons, and after that we need to check the carry flag. So now I'll take, now in this example I'll take subtract instruction. So in the subtract instruction, for example, if I do subtract a comma at r naught, so that time after the execution of this instruction, the contents of accumulator will be changed. The contents of the accumulator will be changed. So that's why to retain the same value, I'll move contents of accumulator to B for the later use. And now increment R naught means the R naught pointer will point to 31H, and in that we are having the data 03. So now we are subtracting A minus at R naught. It's nothing but A is having 05H and at R naught is having 03H. So now we need to check the carry flag to see that which number is larger or which number is smaller. So for that we need to check the carry flag. So carry flag sets if A is less than at R naught. Okay, so the carry flag sets if A is less than R naught, else carry flag will be 0. So now here, if carry flag is equal to 1, if carry flag is equal to 1, is nothing but it tells that the first element is smaller than the second element. So the first element we are having in A and the second element we are having in 31H. So that time no need to exchange anything, because already the smaller number in the top of the block, and somewhere we'll write no exchange. If carry is not generated, is nothing but the first element, that is 05H. The first element 05H is greater than 03H. The first element 05H is greater than 03H. In the example we have seen, at 30H we have 05 and 31H we have 03. So we need to interchange. So this is the critical part in the sorting program. When we are interchanging the data, we should see that we are placing the data in the correct place. Okay, so for that we can do the trial and error, and you need to trace the program so that you will get the correct output. Okay, so let us move A comma at R naught. It's nothing but, now at R naught is nothing but the pointer is at 31H. The pointer is at 31H and contents of 31H03. So after this instruction, we'll get A will be having 03H. A will be having 03H. Okay. So next now, and still our pointer R naught is pointing to 31H, and to 31H we need to move the first data, and according to our program the first data we have copied in the B register also, so we'll move into that. So that is move at R naught comma B. So after this instruction, at R naught means we get 31H, and in 31H we'll get 05. But still in 30H we have 0.05 only. Okay, so now we need to move our 3H into 30H, but our source pointer is pointing to 31H, but we need to move our next accumulator content to 30H. For that, we need to decrement R0. Okay, so when we decrement the R0, the pointer will point to 30H. And now in 30H, we need to store our smallest element, so that is move at R0, A. So after this instruction, in 30H will have 03 and in 31H will have 05, what we need to have according to our logic. So for the next, first comparison is done, and also we have placed the data in the proper location. And next we need to compare the element which is present in the 03 and the element which is present in the 32. So for that, here we have to increment R0, because presently our pointer is in 30H, but we want our pointer in 31H. For that, we increment R0. So when we do this instruction, the pointer will come at 31H. So now we need to repeat the loop, that is DJNZ, and the inner loop we have taken it as R2, and we'll write this as inner loop. Okay, and that should go to here. Okay, and this, if the first number is already smaller than the second number, then no need of these things. Directly we can decrement the inner loop, and we should go back to compare next two numbers. So in this again, move a comma at or not means the R0 is pointing to 31H, so in A will get 05H, and 05H will be compared with 06H. So this loop will be repeated till R2 becomes 0. Now initially R2 is 04H, that is equivalent to R1H. So once this R2 becomes 0, the control will come out of this loop. Next we need to go for the next iteration, and that iteration should be repeat for 4 times, that is 1 less than the block size. So again we need to use DJNZ R1 comma outer loop, and this should go to here, outer loop. So here also this is very important, where we should repeat our outer loop. So that is, here we are repeating here at move R0 comma ash 30H, means again we are initializing R0 to 30H, because in the second iteration again we are starting from 30H. So I hope this logic and the program is clear. And for the descending order, just it is opposite. Instead of JC, we have to use JNC. Means in the descending order, the smallest element should be in the bottom of the array, and the largest element should be in the top of the array. Okay. So in this program, instead of subtraction, we can also make use of compare instruction. So you can try that also. But only thing you need to take care here is, when you are interchanging the data, you have to see that you are placing the data in the proper positions. Thank you.